Over there, Venatori.
This bunch looks tough. Watch your step. I have a serious question for you, Iron Lady.
I can hardly wait.
In the Imperial Court, if someone uses the wrong fork at dinner, is that worse than death or just social suicide?
It's impossible to say, my dear. Anyone who has ever so misstepped was stabbed to death with the proper fork.
Thank you. Impressive, is it not? Fit for a leader, meant to show influence and the burden of it. It is where the Inquisition will sit in judgment. Where you will sit in judgment.
Who will I be judging, exactly?
Those who have done wrong. You will know of them, at the very least. All this presumes they have survived their initial encounter with you, of course.
Will we be taking heads right here in the hall?
Goodness, no! If such an option is available, it will be done elsewhere. And it may not be necessary. The Inquisition's sovereignty is derived from the allies who validate it. You are both empowered and bound. Justice has many tools. If their application is clever, execution may even seem merciful by comparison.
Is there anyone I should judge?
Take the throne when you're ready. We will bring him before you. This was a surprise. After you return from the bogs, we discovered this man attacking the building with a goat. Chief Movran the Under. He feels slighted by the killing of his Avar tribesmen, who repeatedly attacked you first. What should we do with him? Where should he go?
Why is this an issue worth presenting?
A courtroom? Unnecessary. You killed my idiot son, and I answered, as is my custom, by smacking your holdings with goat's blood.
Don't look at me.
No foul. You meant to murder Tvinters, but got feisty with your Inquisition. A red-headed mother guarantees a brat. Do as you've earned, Inquisitor. My clan yields. My remaining boys have brains still in their heads.
I don't know. He could go in that... what's it called? A gibbet? Chief Movran, you'll be placed in a gibbet to serve as an example to... someone. Then, probably released.
Gibbet? Gibbet? Gibbet?
Knight Captain Denham, Inquisitor. He awaits judgment for serving the Lord Seeker at Theronfall Redoubt. I knew some of the knights who died there. I asked to oversee his sentencing. The Envy Demon perhaps fooled the Knight Captain, but following his superior's orders, nearly destroyed the Templars.
We'll find a suitable punishment for the good captain.
I only did as I was told.
Knowingly or not, you condemned your brothers and sisters to death.
You would have done the same if you hadn't abandoned the order. I served faithfully. It went red after what the Lord Seeker told me to do.
I didn't suffer at your hands. That was your knights in the Templar Order. Let the remaining Templars judge the man who failed them.
The penalty will be death. They can't. Not after what I've seen.
The order was sent?
This morning.
Law has asserted itself.
Will.
Honored Inquisitor. Gotzi Sturhald. Did my part on the walls, and now I'm on this strange collection you've brought us. Don't know its worth to the fight exactly, but it's good workmanship.
Where did you learn your skills?
Orzammar. Carved a few statues in my day. You know Paragon Branka? Carved her. When she turned out to be sodding mad, I left. Couldn't stand looking at it. The memory of a dwarf, right?
Any ideas about the origin of these reliefs?
To Vinter, early. It's in the tool marks, the grain. That's hard dust mined from the Hundred Pillars, if I know anything. Oh, I suppose the scene is probably full of Tevinter robes, too.
The Hundred Pillars?
Damnedest things. Massive spires that aren't stone. It's like a mortar. Don't know more than that. Strong, though.
Do you have any insight into the stories these tiles are supposed to depict?
Tell you what. You finish one, and I'll write it up. Who better, right? A good dwarven perspective.
Another time.
Best of the vein, Inquisitor.
Fertile ground, even here. This hold has everything.
Inquisitor, Elan Vemar, honored to represent the College of Herbalists and offer my services as apothecary. I intend to carry on the work of my esteemed colleague, Adan. He thought highly of you. You will be missed.
He didn't seem all that friendly toward me.
A sign of his respect. Smiles are saved for fools, so they leave quickly. All the mundane needs of Skyhold will be well tended. If you note anything special, let me know. I'm here to serve the cause we must.
Ah, Inquisitor, you have finally come into your own. The Maker has put you on a difficult path. I pray you walk it safely.
We're long past the time for prayers.
We are never past the time for prayers, Inquisitor. The Maker has chosen you to deliver us from Corypheus. You have the faith and support of everyone here. Never forget that. Now, was there anything else?
You know, I grew up around humans, but I never learned much about the Chantry. Can you tell me about it?
Of course. Too many think that the Chant of Light should only be sung by humans. The truth is that knowledge of the Maker and Andraste should be open to all who wish to learn of him. We believe the Maker created us, and that mankind's sinful nature caused him to turn away. With Andraste's blessing, the Maker will forgive mankind once the Chant of Light is sung from all corners of this world.
Why does the Chantry allow only human women to become priestesses?
The official doctrine is that elves and dwarves have turned further from the Maker than humanity. And as for men, the chant holds that they are more vulnerable to anger or passion. But in truth, it is simply political, added after Andraste's death, like too many of our beliefs.
If you don't believe these restrictions are what Andraste wanted, why haven't you tried to change them?
Has the current state of the world not taught you the folly of fighting too many battles at once? I chose to use what power I had to help peasants forgotten by the nobles of Orlais. I believed there would be time to address their inequality under the Chantry once we had saved them from starving.
What is your stance on magic?
Andraste put it simply. Magic must serve man, not rule over him. However, those words must be put into the proper historical context. Andraste led a rebellion against the Tevinter Imperium, whose magisters controlled most of the world at the time. Even then, she never called for all mages to be put to death. She believed in peaceful coexistence.
I don't recall the Chantry being as tolerant of magic as you describe.
No. The Chantry is an imperfect vessel, pulled in every direction by those who would steer its course. Yet the Templars rebelled precisely because Divine Justinia was not restrictive enough. Perhaps the Inquisition will find a better way.
There were calls for an exalted march to put down the Mage Rebellion. What was your opinion?
It was ignorant gossip. An exalted march only succeeds when it carries the will of the people. Even then, it cannot be undertaken lightly. People are too easily frightened. We cannot destroy everything they fear. an exalted march is justified only against a true threat to this whole world. It is an offense to the Maker to use it as a political bludgeon, or as a means of spreading the chant of light.
What about the exalted march that conquered the elves?
That is a hotly debated matter in some circles of the Chantry.
The elves had conquered Mont-Saint-Marc and threatened Val-Royaux itself. They were not helpless victims.
But even then, Orlais was the only nation to provide troops. It was hardly an exalted march of all the faithful. The Maker wishes his world to spread by example, not by war. We win no converts with blood.
Farewell.
Maker go with you.
Someone left sliced plums on the windowsill again. The juice is attracting flies. There are spiders everywhere. The plums were right in front of me, but I can't quite recall who took them.
Lord Inquisitor, Bonnie Sims at your service. I trust good secret was not too coarse. Now that you've come to some good fortune, you deserve an upgrade. As master of the tradesmen, I stand ready to supply your every need.
How are you doing? Good business?
Building. Always building, thanks to you.
Who or what are the tradesmen?
A following of sympathetic and profit-minded individuals who promote local craftsmen and fair importers. A guild of sorts. Although that implies counter affiliations we are not interested in crossing. No offense, sincerely. We are merely organized merchants at your service.
What do you bring to the Inquisition?
What you need, and more. It takes great coordination to make a remote location seem central. While there is no doubt the boutiques of Valrieux display the grandest of the grand, they do not travel. At least, not yet.
It's a shame Sigrid didn't survive Haven.
It is, but one must continue.
That's it?
He was a shrewd man, but he was none too pleasant. It was time arrangements were made. I shall make every effort to prove that this is an upgrade.
Why are you a mere merchant if you are the master of this group?
I wish to avoid the suggestion that I am a posturing commander atop a structure of malcontents. It is better to remain active, hands-on. Do you not agree, Inquisitor?
We'll speak another time.
Certainly, Lord Inquisitor.